Hey there, folks. Welcome to show 594. My name is Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. You downloaded the podcast. We got the gang in the studio. We're back in the studio, back from the road. Joining me is Jeff Rubenstein. Hello, Jeffrey.
Hi.
And sitting directly across from you is slightly blue, slightly frozen Laura Massey-Eyed. Laura.
Hello.
Have you recovered from our East Coast swing yet?
This is like a Motown Philly reference. Mm-hmm. Boyz II Men, ABC, BBD.
The East Coast family. Thank you.
I can't top it. Okay, show's over. Good night, everybody.
We're done.
We had a great show last week, although we talked a little bit about the weather. The weather was a little bit rough.
That was chilly.
The coldest PAX we've been to, isn't it?
Wasn't it? I think that's probably the coldest I've ever been.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. 2 years ago was close, but this was single digits. Yeah, We grew up on the East Coast, Larry.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're used to it.
This used to be no big deal. Mm-hmm. We are not used to it now.
Well, Laura and I were walking back, and I was telling her, I said, Laura, see how cold it is? She's like, I said, this is what I dealt with pretty much every single day when I was at Syracuse University, where, you know, you're like, the snow is blowing you don't realize snow blows sideways.
Right.
And it's so cold that your ears feel brittle and they feel like pins and needles.
Yes. Well, I thought my eyeballs were going to freeze.
Which,
it hurt so bad.
Yeah.
I was actually thinking about that. I'm like, my eyeballs are horribly exposed.
Yeah. Trying to like look down.
That's why I had glasses
over
on.
Them.
Yeah. So. Smart.
Nice.
But anyway, we're back in the studio. It was a great time to be at PAX. We had a wonderful time. Thank you, everybody that came to the show. Thank you very much. Everybody that tuned in on Twitch, thank you very much. And thank you to you, Jeff, and you, Laura. You guys came out and you hightailed it out of there like that night.
Look, it was good to be there. And we had a great crowd. And it was really worth it.
Yeah.
It was really awesome.
Yeah.
It definitely was.
Did you have fun?
I had a great time.
Did you?
Yes. I enjoyed every minute of it. And thanks again to everybody who came.
Yeah.
It was fantastic.
Because we can't do it without you guys and girls. But I'm working on... I hate doing this because, you know, I don't like... I'm not really a hype master. I just kind of talk about stuff.
That is what you do for a living, Larry.
No. But I don't like, hey, you're never going to believe this. But I am working on something super cool for PAX Prime.
Oh, he is.
So
I haven't heard about this.
No,
I'm
you haven't.
Looking forward to hearing about
I have something cool that I'll be using at PAX Prime that we're not going to talk about, and working on a cool little. Anyway, that's many many months away. We have so much going on between now and then, but we're tuning in right now. What you're playing, you know, we can talk about what we're playing. Jeff and I are playing a little Mass Effect. Jeffrey,
yeah. So by the time you hear this, I do through EA Access. So through EA Access, you know, we were going to jump on multiplayer, and Larry, we weren't all able to sync up. So I was like, "Oh, I'll go into the creator, you know, and make my new rider." And I was, you know, do I go Fem Rider or Bro Rider?
And what did you do?
Fem Rider.
And what did you name her?
You know, the initial name it gives you is Sarah Rider, and you could change it. And I actually left it. I always like leaving in the default because what I've noticed, and I don't know if this is the case here, but in certain games, they will actually record like the voice of or the name, you know, so instead of just referring to as Ryder, they may use the first name Sarah here and there. So I left it.
Because as you go through the customization, the last name is standard.
Mm-hmm. What is cool though, is that, so you create your character however you like, and then it gives you the opportunity of using either the default, you have a twin brother or sister, depending on what you choose. So I think this is what was cool about, Bro Shep in Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3 does not exist. He's on another timeline, and he's in the multiverse. Whereas here, both the characters will exist, and it's just a matter of which one you will control versus the other sibling will be in the story. But then you have the opportunity as like you change races or, you know, skin color,
the whole
features,
thing.
Whatever. They alter, if you like, your twin brother or sister to look like you're all part of the same family, which I thought was,
you know, what I named mine.
What?
So I went female as well.
Mm-hmm.
I named her Red.
Red Rider. I did think of going Rough Rider.
Ruff. Also good. Also
little DMX.
Good.
And then I was just like, that's stupid.
I gave her red hair too.
Yeah. Oh well.
Funny.
Actually, said I. But anyway.
Baby gun.
Maybe. Shoot your eye out, kid.
Wow, that's really good. So yeah, I jumped in, played the first hour. I would say anything in that game is a spoiler, including the achievement list.
Right.
So
yeah, right.
Which they did not hide plot points under hidden achievements. I would just recommend just don't even look at the achievement list. And coming from me, I you know, someone who obsessively reads xboxachievements.com or True Achievements, don't look. And so anyway, did that. We should play a little multiplayer this weekend. I think would be fun.
Yeah, that'd be super fun.
We should. Should we talk about what happened in Boston after the after we did the show?
Yeah, let's do it.
So we're all back in my hotel room, and Jeff, you're working on something. Yeah. And I had brought my Switch with me.
Yes, you did.
And Laura hadn't seen it because I'm playing Zelda. Jeff's playing Zelda. You don't have a Switch yet. And you and I were playing the demo game.
Right.
We were playing the, what was it?
Snipperclips.
Snipperclip that I had downloaded. And you and I, so you and I, you have one of the Joy-Cons and I have one of the Joy-Cons. And I don't have it on the big TV. We're huddled around this little tiny, 6 or 7 inch screen, right?
Right. And it's one of the first local multiplayer games I've played on a handheld.
Right.
Like something that's portable.
Right.
Usually you have to pass it back and forth if you're playing it, but this is brand new to me, which is I can play on a Joy-Con, you can play on a Joy-Con.
Right, we were playing at the same time. In fact, we had to work together. We had to solve puzzles.
We did.
And
it must have been very entertaining for Jeff.
Yeah, that's right.
What is
you were sitting on the couch with us and he was like, I kept looking over at him and he was giggling and you and I were just like.
I was supposed to be working on like a deck and I just, there was so much giggling happening. Here, the other thing was, this game must be challenging because two of the smartest people I know, I'm really rounding up here for your sake,
thank
Laura.
You. Thank you for
we're really having like a tough go of it. Yeah. It looks like it's a kid's game.
Well, I'm just going to say this. I was having like flashbacks to high school.
Oh, no.
Where I'm teamed up with a really smart girl in the class and I'm dumb. And I'm watching, you're like, you know exactly what to do. And I'm like, yeah, I just, what do I do? What do I do? Yeah, right. So I felt like I was dragging you down. So I have to apologize, Laura.
Okay.
I felt like I was dragged because you looked at that it was fascinating for me watching you pull this thing apart and dissect it and trying to figure out what we're, because you have to take these, for those of you that don't know, you each have a character and they're one dimensional, actually they're two dimensional. And they have to, basically you're given a task on screen and it could be, hey, you have to fill in this shape. It's a dotted line or
basically
you have to
match the hole or something like that.
So, and basically when your characters overlap, you can cut parts out of each other to kind of like, I can cut you can cut me, and we can kind of create the shapes, or in the shape of the balloon one, we created a pointy thing and we popped balloons.
That one was probably the longest one for us to figure out.
Yeah, yeah.
That one's probably the most entertaining as well.
So I apologize, Laura, I apologize. I apologize that
it was really fun.
I feel like I disappointed you.
I will say it was pretty cool to see you two playing like co-op game, like together, same screen, like portable.
Right.
It's well done.
So anyway, it's a free demo, actually. If you want to download that, if you have a Switch, go ahead and download that. So anyway.
And let us know how it goes.
Yeah, let us know how that goes. Pick somebody out who you may or may not be friends with. This is always a problem when you and I play games like that where you need to cooperate, is that I'm always afraid you're just going to, I mean, you already know I'm an idiot. So you're just going to like, it's going to put icing on that cake. Anyway. Jeffrey.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry.
I was going to say you were a very pleasant partner.
That you're very kind. Thank you very much. Well, we figured it out.
Because we eventually figured them all out.
Yeah, that's the beauty of the game. And then, actually, by the time we finished it, the demo was over.
Exactly.
Right?
We played the entire demo. We got all the way to the end.
I felt bad because you left. Because remember, you went right to the airport.
Yes.
Like, I turned to Jeff like, did I piss her off? She just kind of stormed out of here. Jeez.
Didn't want to be late.
Yeah, but you got out of there safely, didn't you?
Yeah,
I was delayed many, many hours.
We all did.
As were a lot of people.
Yes, they were. But we're done with that. We're talking about what we're playing. Let's continue on with what you're playing there, Jeffrey.
Yeah. So in addition to Zelda, which is just an incredible game. It's very, very, very good. In our house, one of the games that's sort of like taken over with all the people, all the different gamers in the house, is The Witness. And so
which has been out on Xbox One for quite some time.
Yeah, probably since last fall, maybe. So, like, my brother beat it. He's smart. He's an engineer. You should play Snipperclips with him. And so I, like, purposely, whenever he would play it, I would make sure, unless he was really stumped, I would help him, you know, we would try to work through it together. But it's actually kind of a great co-op game in that way.
Where you're sitting all together.
Yeah, trying to work your way through it. Because otherwise it can be really, you know, you can hit a mental block.
And it's fantastic to have an additional perspective
to
say, oh, why don't you look over there? I have an idea
where
you wouldn't have had that idea otherwise.
So we were looking through like the desert pyramid, which I was kind of killing it. Then I got up to something.
I don't think I made it that far.
It's actually pretty close to the beginning, but obviously—
Is it off to the left?
It depends on which way you're facing, I guess.
Maybe. Spoiler island.
Yeah. But I guess, you know, you can go wherever you want.
Yeah.
before you discover the boat, you're likely to end up in this desert area. Mm-hmm. And I was blowing boat? Through it, but then I came up to like a part where I just couldn't figure it out. And like my 7-year old figured it out.
Oh, good.
So like, why don't you go back there? And so mm-hmm. she's actually further in the game. That she hit her 7th laser yesterday.
What?
Which is crazy.
Wow.
I had to help her out. The only one was with the sound one, which it was pretty cool. Like they started getting into ones where you're hearing like birds chirping and that's how you do it. Like if it's mm-hmm. a higher low pitch and then they make it more and more complicated. That was actually that's been my favorite puzzle so far. So anyway, the Witness is as yes. an underrated co-op game.
It is a very clever game.
Yeah.
Impressively clever.
Yeah. So that, and I'm just going to be really sinking a lot of time, I think, into Mass Effect. Oh, and I mean, we've talked about this before, but my favorite couch secondary activity game, if like the TV's on and I kind of don't care, is Stardew Valley. It's all about Stardew
I know.
Valley.
You're all doing the
Stardew Runs really Valley. Well on the surface.
Laura, you're next. Did you have a chance to play anything when we were traveling?
I played a few minutes of a game.
What did you play?
So I went home and I downloaded Robo Recall.
Oh, I played it too.
Yes,
no, no, you're 100% right. You talk and then I will affirm everything you said because I forgot about that.
Go on.
Because I had so much fun at PAX and you heard me talk about that, you know, last week.
Mm-hmm.
But I went home and I bought it mm-hmm. and now I'm playing it. It's mm-hmm. super fun.
Good.
Super fun. I don't think...
Why don't you remind people that didn't hear PAX what it is?
It is a VR game on the Oculus. I think you can also get it on the Vive through other means. And you are shooting robots. And it is one of the best looking games.
This is the one you were talking about on the show last week. When we were at PAX, right?
Yes. And it is one of the most immersive games I've ever played in VR. Where you feel like you are doing amazing as you are shooting these robots. Like, it feels... amazing.
You feel like a hero in this game. So I was at South by Southwest and I had, we were there doing some meetings.
So
and
you went there after PAX.
Yes, directly from PAX.
Right.
And it wasn't as warm as I would have liked, but it wasn't 9 degrees.
It wasn't
9 degrees. And I ate my weight in queso, which I feel great.
Oh my gosh, fantastic. I miss queso.
The queso's so good.
So good.
So, we're walking around and we notice, oh, there's the Dell, like they sort of have like a building. They had taken over a building, which is kind of what like a lot of companies do down during South by Southwest. And I know a couple of people on the Alienware team and a couple of people on the Dell team. I was like, well, you know, I'm going to go in there and we'll say hi and just see what they're working on. Spoiler alert, some cool stuff. They I don't know if you ever saw that OLED. We had brought it into the office. They have like basically like the smallest laptop with I think it has a 1070, but with like a Pascal graphics chip in it from NVIDIA and has an OLED screen. Basically, it's like the smallest laptop you could run VR with. And they have like an updated version now with like the new processor, like an even better version.
Sure.
So that's really cool. Anyway, trust me. But then I looked over and I was like, oh, they had an Oculus and a Vive there. And I was like, they had Robo Recall in there. And I was like, one of my colleagues said that this was the most fun she's ever had playing a game. So I got on there.
Awesome.
Did you get on the Oculus or Vive?
They had it on the Oculus. I think for Vive, you have to like get a mod or something. I hadn't heard that from me.
Yeah.
But, I'd never used the Oculus touch controllers before. I'd used the Vive a lot and I like it. So I figured, well, this is a chance to do it. And you were right. It is so much fun. And you can like, these robots are just coming from everywhere. But the thing that I like is when they get close to you, like you can grab them and throw them, or you can just punch them and they just like go, you feel like Iron Man or something.
Yes.
And at one point one thing that it does well is in VR, when you're moving around, like the way you would in a first person shooter, it can actually be a little disconcerting, but you, in this game, you can warp around and which makes it so you don't feel that.
So it runs on Windows 10, right?
Of course.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. And so I warped up to the top of a, like a awning or something. And I stood up there and like occasionally like a robot would come up there and you would just grab him and chuck him, or you'd slam two of them together.
What's a win state?
There are levels.
They have levels. Okay.
And
it's not just an onslaught of robots.
No, there are levels. There's progression. There's objectives to do in each of the levels.
Okay.
There's maybe 3 or 4 objectives per level. And in some objectives, it's to shoot as many robots as you can. In another objective, it's to throw robots into a portal that teleports them away.
Right. Waste receptacle.
Yeah. Perhaps. There's also an ability to upgrade your weapons, where you go into the weapon zone.
Is this where you get your shotguns?
Yeah, you can holster different weapons. You unlock different weapons, and then you can accessorize your weapons with sight lines or silencers.
Oh man, I didn't get that far.
And, yeah,
Oh, you have the game now. Okay. But one of the coolest things is when you're shooting and then you're out of ammo, like you said, you throw them away. Mm-hmm. It's sort of like I've never felt more like Antonio Banderas in Desperado.
Right.
You know, just chuck the gun, or like Reaper, and then you just reach down to your hip, thing, and you just pull them out there.
More.
And I did a little Death Blossom action.
Did
I will say that. Yeah.
I would expect nothing less.
Yeah, and I actually whacked somebody because I forgot that I was in VR.
Yeah.
And I got just so into it, and I was like, oh, I'm sorry, sir or madam. Yes, I'll apologize later.
Yeah. Good.
Right in the chest.
So anyway, that's what you're playing, Laura, mm-hmm. So that sounds like great.
Yeah,
we should put a link to that in the notes there,
yeah,
Jeff,
yeah,
if you can.
I also took E's advice and tried out Space Pirate Trainer.
Right.
Which you've played that one.
Yeah, that's a really good one.
It's also really fun. It's a completely different mechanic, but you are shooting robots in that one as well. But this one is endless onset of wave after wave after wave of robots, and they just get more progressively
robots.
Harder. And then you have a shield where you can defend yourself. So it's a little bit different.
I think I played that one, yeah.
It's a little bit different, but it's a shorter gameplay,
sure,
with no progression. So
I
kind of get bored after a little while.
Understandable.
At least I do.
Understandable.
Rogue Girls get at least some, you know, some levels and some progression. So
mm-hmm.
It keeps you in it. So I'm playing that. Super fun.
Sweet.
It's almost like exercise.
Well,
I was sweating.
Yeah.
I was absolutely sweating.
That's because you were in between taco feeding.
Oh, yeah. Like queso was coming out of my
okay,
pores,
yeah.
But it was still great.
I got to go play some VR, and then I'm going to be right back torchies.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, I know.
So
I know.
Good.
Good. So that you've had a... Again, thank you guys for coming out.
You're very welcome.
I'm playing Mass Effect. We talk about Zelda. Jeff and I were playing... You know, Jeff and I were on a plane together. We talked about that during the show.
Oh, on the way
yeah.
up.
And on the way
to,
over to Boston. And I was sitting in the center seat.
I gave him the armrest.
That's very kind of you,
Jeff. I think it's a
you know what
corner,
I gave him?
A pillar of our society.
I gave him my barf bag.
Oh,
have we archived last week's show?
Only VOD.
All right, so the most people probably have. Yeah. So my fear.
Yes.
Because I had the window seat, which of course the one time I feel like I might have to run up to the bathroom, I have the window seat,
mm-hmm.
And my fear was just vomiting on Larry.
Going all over me.
Yeah, so. I woke up and it was just, I was in a bad state, but I was like, I'm going to PAX.
Yeah, I saw him that morning. He's like,
yeah.
I can get breakfast. Oh, no. It'll be fine.
So Larry handed me his barf bag and I like sort of tucked it in the back of the chair, just with like the lip up. And I was like testing like my quick draw action. Like how quickly can I grab this bag?
It was pretty quick.
If need be. Yeah, fortunately it was not necessary because I became so agitated watching Larry kill poor Link in many ingenious ways that eventually.
Look. It's when you get a new video game, you learn how to, you're like, can I do this? No,
you
dice.
Press all the
do this. Let's go all the things. You pick up all the things. You jump off all the things.
Jump into all the
and
things.
That's what
get
I was
eaten
doing.
By all the things.
That's what I was doing.
Yes.
Made significant progress since we last spoke, Jeff, though.
Oh, good.
You're ahead of me.
Yeah. So there we go.
Can't complain.
Elephant. That's all I'll say.
Elephant.
Yeah.
It's a mystery.
Yeah, it's a mystery wrapped in an enigma.
Mm-hmm.
Playing Mass Effect. We need to get back into Overwatch. We got some Ghost Recon we got to catch up on. There's some other things that we need to do that I can't really talk about. We got some other games, yeah.
All the secret stuff that's happening.
It's all the secret stuff that's happening.
It's that time of year for secret stuff.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
You're like... In lounge, full on lounge singer mode. By the way, your glasses match your sweater today,
yes,
which
they
is
that okay?
Stylish.
Is no, that all right?
Good.
Very stylish.
I just, you know, I just try to, you know, it's spring. I'm trying to dress for spring.
You're there. Not quite pastel. But,
you know, we didn't really talk about this, but, you know, because what happened, but normally I stay out in New England for the week and we weren't going to do a show this week.
Right.
But when the blizzard started knocking on the door, mm-hmm. I was like, I'm out of here. So I flew out early and unfortunately have disappointed my family to the maximum. So, yeah, mom and my sisters are none too pleased with me. It's like, but you grew up here. I'm like, yeah, I know, but I don't live there anymore. See you later. Bye.
You made the right call.
Yeah, based on the photos I saw. But anyway. All right. Well, Jeff, you got some news we can go over there?
I do.
We got some stuff to go through in the show. We didn't have any interviews last week or this week based, you know, because we had a couple last week. So we're kind of keeping a nice, clean, tight show. This is more of a surprise, a pop-up show, if you will.
Yeah. It was nice to have Mac there
right.
last week from the Mass Effect team.
Yeah,
so
he was great.
Congrats to them. These guys will be launching. I mean, if you have EA access, you're already playing.
You're
if
in.
Not,
you're in.
The rest of you this coming Tuesday. Depending on when you're listening to this, this may be your last day or next to last day to get an Xbox One S Minecraft Favorites Bundle for just $249.
Yeah, what are you waiting for?
So that deal goes from the time you're hearing this through, or from the March 12th through March 18th.
Yeah, so this weekend is that US
this
in
is
the
just
US.
Just about the end of it, so in the US. So, but yeah, that's a pretty darn good deal. Also,
yes,
we are now into the second half of March. We have without incident past the Ides of March.
We're in the second half of March.
Yeah, I know.
How did that happen?
Which means the second half of March's Games with Gold are now available for download. That is Evolve Ultimate Edition.
Yeah.
Awesome. And Heavy Weapon, which was, I feel like, one of the first arcade games.
You're
Xbox
right.
Live, going back over
back
this.
In the day. Classic and oldie but a goodie.
And that is backwards compatible. And actually, speaking of backwards compatibility,
yeah.
Highlight of this week's trove of games, Street Fighter IV.
Right.
Awesome.
I feel like that may be the best fighting game of all time. There's a lot of arguments to be made, but I certainly played just a ton of Street Fighter IV, and I thought that was
fighting
awesome.
Games. I was never any good at them for some reason.
Neither was I.
Yeah, I just when I on my the years I spent in the arcade with the stand up, I was that sucker just pumping quarters, and I was the Patsy.
See, when I was in high school is when fighting games were really coming out. I think it was like a freshman when Street Fighter II came out, and it was just like it was like a moth to a flame, like all of the kids in the class would just like after school, you were going to a bowling alley, to an arcade if there was an arcade nearby. And this was sort of like an era when arcade games would be in places where you didn't expect. Like, this doesn't happen now. Mm-hmm. Like, arcades are arcade games are in an arcade or
they're on your phone
or in Barcade or on your phone, but they're kind of hard to find. But like when I was growing up, like restaurants might have a couple of like a Pac-Man machine in the front or something
Pizza
like that.
Pizza Hut had a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle machine, and that's what I played all the
exactly,
time.
Exactly,
that was your jam?
Yeah, it was my jam.
So Street Fighter was sort of in a lot of places. Oh, no, you got something to say here?
Like? Wait a minute. I'm sorry, could we just rewind a little bit? Bowling alley? You spent some time in a bowling alley?
Spent a lot of time in bowling alley.
As did I.
I shot a lot of pool.
Did you?
Yeah, I actually the bowling.
Do you have a leather
pool?
Jacket that says the Jets?
No, because back then people would smoke in a bowling alley, and leather would just soak up all that smell. And you would just stink. It was
okay.
Gross. This was the 90s.
Did you ever spend time in a bowling alley, Laura?
A little bit of time,
as little as possible.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing: the bowling alley near me was only a quarter for Mortal Kombat and Mortal Kombat 2 and 3, not 50 cents.
Did you ever play Duckpin or Candlepin?
I don't know what that is.
Really?
Neither do I.
Yeah, in New England, we had regular bowling, but they also had duck pin, which are shorter, squatter pins, and then candle pin, which is, look it up, is circular pins. So it's completely like a tall, circular pin.
Does it just make it much harder?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The little pins.
Yeah, duck pin and candle pin. And the duck pin, if I remember correctly, the balls were smaller. They were like bocce balls.
Oh. Whoa, the... Candle pin. It's like bowling into a menorah.
See?
It's,
just like...
yeah, that looks super difficult. Bowling wasn't difficult enough already.
Yeah. I don't remember the size of the candle pin ball. Maybe Wikipedia will tell you, but I remember the duck pin were absolutely... You could just take them and if you... Like, I remember I had a couple friends who were on the softball team and they would just underhand those things and boom! We are off.
It's like a shot put.
Yeah, it was.
All right, I'll link to those because my big hand is weird stuff.
Boom. That was a...
Oh, yeah, and not only that, but it's just, like, the Wikipedia is just like, this is a Boston thing.
Yeah. Yep.
Although there's a set of lanes in Wyoming. Oh, no, Wyoming, Ohio. I didn't know that was a place. That's the closest we're going to get.
Okay.
Anyway, that's what happens when you look at Wikipedia on the fly.
Back compat.
Back? Oh, yeah. Oh, no.
that's where we ended.
Yeah, so Street Fighter IV. It was really good. Yeah, but the fighting games, man, back then, it was cool because when you played in the arcade... It wasn't about latency all that because there is no latency. It was about like physical positioning, and I was really skinny in high school, and so a larger person could like sort of muscle you out.
Oh, push you away from the
they would stand like essentially in the middle, and you're sort of hanging off the edge.
Oh, there was
like
a whole physical element that you do not get today.
Oh,
yeah,
no.
Yeah. It could be very intimidating. There would be times I'd go into the arcade, and I'm like, I don't want to stand here and play next to that person because I'm afraid they will just destroy me, like physically, like jump me if I win, you know, or I'm worried that I'll just
or just because.
Yeah. Well, I mean, which happened a couple times.
Because it is a bowling alley
in Miami, but yeah, it is. The whole element seems to be gone today, but that's probably for the best.
Probably.
Anyway, Street Fighter IV, backwards compatibility, this flashback brought to you by age.
I want to go find a candlepin bowling place now or duckpin and take you. Next time we go to Boston, we'll go to duckpin or candlepin bowling, all right?
I love this idea.
Do you approve?
This is so strange.
I know that Laura will only go if it's 9 degrees outside. The only reason she's really going in there is to get away from the outside.
Perhaps. I do have my own bowling shoes, though.
Wait a minute, what?
Yes.
Are you some strange size that you had to require them, or did you just, were you on the bowling team? Were you?
No.
Wow.
No, strangely enough, I bought them for dancing. They're really good for dancing because they have a soft your toe.
You're right.
And a hard heel.
Are they funny colors?
No, it's white. I try to get normal looking bowling shoes. Because then when I took dancing lessons, that's what I would wear.
Wow.
Because they're much cheaper than normal.
If Laura had a bowling nickname, what would it be? What would be on the back of your jersey?
What would be inscribed on my ball?
Right, on your ball and your ball bag, your carrier. Your carrier, yes. Right?
What would that be? My leather jacket.
You think about that. Well, certainly, I mean, lollipop. What else?
Could yeah, mm-hmm. but with the bowling ball instead of the lollipop. Yeah.
What color would your ball be? Pink?
It would be lollipop.
That's
color.
Really, that's just.
What? I'm just asking.
I wonder if they could get a swirl.
Yeah, the swirl would like a lollipop. That's what I'm talking about. All right.
You don't have a bowling ball?
Me?
Yeah.
No, I don't have a bowling ball.
Do you?
A little I do.
Wait, you have a bowling ball?
It's literally the only possession from my dad that I have.
Really?
And, but we had the same. The hands fit perfectly, which of course makes sense. So I have the bowling ball in like a totally 80s bag.
I want to take a photo of it.
Yeah.
Put it on Instagram.
I'll find where it's at. But it's literally
So it's interesting because you have that. And one of the only things I have for my dad is a stapler.
Oh. Was it a swing line?
Oh, yeah.
Well, at least
it was back in the day.
And you want to hold on to that one.
Both of them could do damage. Trust me. You know, it's like rock, paper, scissors.
A couple more news bits here. The ID at Xbox Game Fest is now into week 3. And so what's happening is for the last few weeks is a huge percentage or a huge chunk of great ID at Xbox indie games are having a huge percentage off. So some of the games worth mentioning here would be Night Squad, Reagan Gorbachev. Did you ever play that?
I played that, yeah. That's a good one.
It's so bizarre. Like it's like a buddy movie between the two of them. Don't Starve, Shipwrecked. Shantae Half Genie Hero, Axiom Verge, which is a very cool Metroidvania type game, and Manuel Samuel, which is the conceit of that game is like very awesome. Did we talk about this game before?
No,
I don't think so.
I don't recall.
It's about someone who a boy or a young guy who died, but he's so lazy and he was so spoiled, he doesn't actually know how to like do anything, including walking properly or breathing. And so you have to manually control every single one of these moves. It's sort of like Quap, if you ever messed around with Quap, but like with better graphics. But it's so funny. And there's just great animations, like when you forget to breathe and all of a sudden you're like, why is he turning blue? Oh, I didn't hit the B button to breathe or whatever.
So you're like
it might
the
be.
Brain?
No, you're like almost like he's almost like a marionette.
Right.
And you have to help him just go through normal mundane tasks like making breakfast or getting in a car or whatever it might be. But like all the things that your brain stem does without you thinking about it, you have to think about it.
All right.
And it's a very interesting game.
That is interesting.
And it's on sale. I'll link to that one. I like that game. There was just a big update. Speaking of indie titles, Xbox Play Anywhere title Everspace, which is pretty fun, has just been adding, ever since it went into early access, has been adding tons and tons of new stuff. Huge update, including new ships, new perks. I believe they actually updated the game engine to make it work better on both Windows 10 and on Xbox One.
Yep.
I feel like they might be getting pretty close to hitting 1.0. I was just taking a look on their website the other day, the folks from Rockfish Games. So that one is definitely worth checking out. And then Trove is a new release by the folks at Tryon. It's made with voxels, and for that alone, it's worth mentioning. Think blocky, Minecraft-esque sort of visuals. The game, of course, is different. And Death Squared is a cooperative puzzle game for up to four folks.
Head over to majornelson.com, my blog. You can see
all
the releases and more. Also, if you follow me on Twitter at Major Nelson, I'll tell you when those games with gold are available. Or I'll just tell you what I'm eating for lunch. So you just never know you never know what you're going to get.
Free stuff or
free stuff. That's right. Free information. You're gonna get something. Is going to amuse or irritate you. I'll just pretty much guarantee that, because it's the internet. Laura, you have named the game from a couple weeks ago. I know there's some folks who were a little disappointed we didn't do it at PAX.
Right.
We normally don't do that feature when we're live on location because it's a little more difficult because it requires a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. It requires the clip from before. Requires a new clip, and
that's
it.
Right. So we just do it here in the studio.
So why don't we go ahead and roll the clip?
Yeah, let's do Name the Game from last time.
Hornet reporting, over.
Thank you. Infantry level 1 researched.
Name of the game from last time, and it was Halo Wars 2. Yeah. It was a pretty easy one.
Yeah. Also, we're playing that too.
Yes.
On the road, cross-platform, all sorts of stuff.
Play anywhere.
I'm playing the anywhere.
And the winner is Allison from Arizona.
Allison, we have a lady winner.
Yes, and her gamer tag is Bad Alley Cat.
Bad Alley Cat. Yeah. Sweet.
I bet she goes to the bowling alley.
Where is she?
That would be a good bowling name.
Well, the bowling alley I used to go to in college was Alley Cat's in Gainesville, Florida.
Nice.
Allison, do you bowl? Let us know. But doesn't matter if you bowl or not, because you're a winner. Yeah, what'd you win, Laura?
She has a lot of cool stuff coming her way.
All right, what do you got?
She's got a copy of Trove, the Essentials Pack.
Yep.
Which is the add-on for the new free-to-play game, which is Trove.
Yep.
And she gets a copy of Death Squared, which is a new ID Xbox game. A copy of Blue Collar Astronaut, which is also a new ID Xbox game. A copy of Dark Arcana, The Carnival.
Yep.
Which is a new ID Xbox game.
Yeah.
You can see a theme here.
Yeah.
And another game, the Neurovoider, which is another new ID Xbox
Neurovoider.
Neurovoider.
Oh, yeah. I think I talked about it on the show this week. Yes. On this week on Xbox.
This
sorry.
Week on Xbox.
Sorry, my other show.
But that's not all.
That's not all. What?
Allison also gets a copy of EA Access for 30 days.
Oh, she can try all the games in the vault out.
Exactly.
Nice.
So now she could even play Mass Effect before most other people.
She sure can.
And that's not all. She also gets a copy of Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands Deluxe Edition.
Ooh, look at her go.
And? She also gets an Xbox wireless controller.
Wow.
Which is the Winter Forces Special
Edition.
Well,
that's a nice one. Have you seen that? That's a good one.
That's beautiful.
The timing, only a few days left in winter.
Yeah, right? Allison, nice work. You just cleaned up a whole bunch of stuff there. Those are, of course, we send you codes so you get the digital version of the games. You can fully embrace the digital lifestyle. Mm-hmm. So it's we'll get an email out to you there. So, all right. Well done.
Thank you. And I bet people are wondering, how do they win?
I don't know. How do they win? Prices? Why don't you tell me?
Well, it's really easy.
Tell the listeners, dear Laura.
You can play Name the Game and you too could win.
Yep.
It's really easy. All you have to do is listen to the sound effects that I'm about to play.
Yep.
And then send me an email with what game that's from.
That's right. All you have to do is listen. And I will tell you this right now. You do not need to own your own bowling shoes. You can, but it's not a requirement. So you ready?
All right. Let's roll it. So that was Name the Game for this week. If you think you know what game those sounds are from, just send me an email, lollipop@xbox.com and ccmajor@xbox.com.
Yep. Microsoft employees are not allowed to participate. And there's the rules are on an FAQ over on my blog. So.
Right. So good luck to all the listeners.
And you'll win cool stuff.
Who knows what you could win?
Yeah, I know. Apparently you go into my, I don't know how you get into my office.
Ew.
I'm always there. And I'm like, oh, I never, Laura's, I just come, I don't, you know, I've figured it out. You're using your bowling shoes and you're coming up over the door. I just figured it out. It's crazy, Laura.
You never know. Yeah. I have those connections.
All right, we're getting ready to wrap up the show. I don't know if you guys have anything to add. Do we have anything to add, Laura? I mean, this is kind of like I say, a surprise show since we were not scheduled to be in the studio this week. I've got a couple things. I got my gaming PC back.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, it was upgraded. They put a new processor in it, new motherboard, you know, just got everything ready.
What are you going to test it out with?
I don't know. I gotta find something good to test. Maybe, you know, maybe I'll play Roboblox or Robo Recall.
Do you have an Oculus?
I don't have an Oculus. I have a Vive.
Okay.
So well, try I think that. I though I think someone I know must have an Oculus. Looks at Laura. So yeah, I'm sure we can figure that out. But yeah, I haven't decided what I'm gonna play yet, but I'm gonna get back into it and get my. I'm gonna finish up Halo Wars on it.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Because we were playing that cross-platform. Mm-hmm. I just kind of wanted to play it on my big 4K monitor.
Yes. Oh, so I bet that looks really nice.
So sharp.
Yes.
You know, it's, when you use a 4K monitor, it's the same thing when you're on the web or, you know, whether you're using like a Mac or Windows, it looks so good in 4K. But then when you find that weird part of the operating system that they never updated, mm-hmm. the icon, it's like, ooh.
And it's really big.
Yeah, and it's really big and blocky. And I've seen them both on Windows and the Mac side. They'll get there. All right, Jeffrey, what else before? Because I know you got to run. Laura's got to finish up your lunch over there.
I do.
Yeah, I got to finish up your lunch. I appreciate you coming into the show.
Yeah.
So.
Thanks for having me.
All right. Well, we may be back next week. Who knows? Sometimes we plan to be here. Sometimes we're not. Sometimes we don't not plan to be there. And sometimes we are.
Count me in if you're doing it.
We're getting ready for E3. Jeff and I will be there, right?
Oh, yes.
Okay, Laura. We're still trying to get Laura to go.
Yes.
We barely got her to PAX.
That's true.
Yeah, your plane ride coming in was
just
a little bit rough, but
way too late.
But we'd love to have you down. It's only two and a half hours away down to LA as opposed to the
six hours.
Four out, six back, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. It's crazy. All right, gang, hit us up on Twitter. You can find Laura and her bowling shoes at...
at Laura Lollipop.
You can find Jeff and his bowling ball.
Thank you. Well done. At Jeff Rubenstein.
And you can find me and my candle pins at Major Nelson. We'll talk to you guys next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye. Bye-bye.